None of us could have ever predicted this.
Division video. Render one, take one. Hey there guys, welcome back to another Division video. Today I want to explain my defense build, and in order for me to do that, first I got to explain why I have multiple characters that are level 30. Pretty much, I'm tired of this is my new little tune I'm leveling up. I'm tired of constantly chopping and changing out gear on one tune, and then forgetting because I didn't write it down, or forgetting where this mod is or that mod, and accidentally, you know, decomping something or selling something, and I'm just tired of running that risk anymore. So I figured, I mean, hell, literally it only took me like 22 hours and change to get these two tones to level 30. I mean, literally they're both one day 3 hours and one day 3 hours and 44 minutes. Like I said, guys, it's easy to get a tune to level 30. It really is. So let's go on about the defense build. So we're going to load in here real quick. Edit breakpoint here. Okay guys, so here we are, meet the defense build. Pretty much it is a four-piece defense set, so that's a chest, backpack, face and knee pads, with a pair of gunslinger gloves with Savage, a critical hit chance increased by 7% against targets out of cover, and a pair of sturdy operator holster, increase armor by 15% when staying more than 4 seconds in the same cover. The shield does count as you being in cover, so technically I'm glitching the game. So I trust me guys, try this, it does work, and it's fun. Now first things first, I am strictly built mere towards firearms and tanking than I am electronics. The only reason why I even have electronics is I believe it's my bag. No, it's not even my bag. I think it's mostly just from, yeah, it's my mask, isn't it? Is it my mask? Yes, my mask is electronics, which you can reroll. Of course, this has got critical hit chance and enemy armor damage. Now, the defense set does state that the fourth point is allow SMG use if one is equipped when ballistic shield is deployed. SMG crit chance is reduced to zero. Yes, the base SMG chance on the gun is reduced to zero. However, you can increase it with things like pulse and various other skills, i.e. mods on your gun. So of course, what you want to do when it comes to your gun is you want to mod the crap out of it for crit hit chance. Like I said, I'm using the First Wave Vector 45 ACP, but if we go to my vault real quick, you'll see that I have literally gone chewed through a metric butt ton of SMGs, burst fires, converted SMG 9s, enhanced PP 19s. I've gone through so many SMGs. Here you go, there's an MP7 that I went through them all, and I mean through all of them. A Navy MP5N, like I said, you got some more Curious Victors. I went with Predatory Accurate Sustain. I've mixed it up, I've tried it with several other SMGs, and I found that the First Wave this one with the ferocious, deadly, and responsive is the best one that works so far, bar none. Now, mods on this sucker, I've gone with the VX1 scope. You can go with others, of course, that increase your crit hit chance or your crit hit. For example, I mean, the little rugged mini reflex is another 7.5%, and I just recently got that in a drop. But I'm not interested in that right now. Of course, I'm with a 108 extended mag crit hit chance and rate of fire with a small laser pointer. Again, you can swap these out for mods as long as it's crit hit chance or crit hit damage. That's what you're going for here, guys. Okay, and yes, I do have the blind skin because I recently hit rank 40 in the underground. And of course, as a backup weapon, you've got tactical ACR with brutal, self-preserved, and ferocious for when your shield finally does fall. And eventually your shield will fall if you overextend or if you've got a really crappy team. Of course, I've got this LMG backup as a backup LMG in case someone else wants to take over the defense role. Now, again, this is what gear you want. I mean, I've seen people run Barrett's chest. I don't own a Barrett's chest. I've tried farming Lexington at least maybe 600-700 times now, and not once has a single chest dropped for me. Not once. Not bloody once. Now, we're rocking 5,413 DPS, 4,908 toughness, and 3,938 skill power. Now, this is how you break out your abilities. Your riot shield, the stock riot shield, will have 775,000 hit points. The assault riot shield has 1.6 million. The assault shield, which doesn't make any sense because I honestly think that the... anyway, long story short, this is the one you want to go with, is the mod reactive target. And why? Because it pulses the targets who shoot your shield. And we're back. Sorry about that, guys. You want to go with the mod reactive targeting. Now, in 1.6, the defense build will automatically default you to the kinetic breaker. You will lose the ability to use all three of these, so you're going to have to learn this. Now, what does increase your shield's hit points is your electronics skill. Basically, and I'll show that in another build, but your electronics... The more electronics you have, the more health points your right shield has. So in theory, you could drop a couple of points out of your health or out of your firearms and go straight into the electronics. Talents. I've decided to go with the following talents. We've gone with triage. Heal an ally with a skill to reduce cooldowns by 15%. That can be swapped out completely. Strike back, reach low health to reduce active skill cooldowns by 20%. That's really good if you're running a heal and you've someone flanked you and you didn't realize it, and while you're trying to back up to counter flank them with your riot shield, your heals regenerate, your heal cooldowns hit, so you can pop it so you're back alive again. Of course, we went with precision. Headshot a target to pulse them for 10 seconds. And of course, one is none. The one is none talent is vital for this build. So there you go. So that is the abilities. And of course, speaking of abilities, I went with the defibrillator first aid build. One, I can heal myself, and two, I can also help a downed ally. So there we go. We've gone over the gear, we've gone over the equipment. Now let's go over something most critical, and that's the mods. Of course, I've gone straight with skill haste and health with the prototypes right there. On the backpack, we have gone with ballistic shield damage resilience and ballistic shield damage resilience. We stacked that. We want to stack as much as that as we can, not damage. Now, because that mod is currently broken, it's currently bugged. Ballistic shield damage resistance and exotic damage resistance, because they're going to throw grenades at you. Fire, we just want flat armor there with that mod. But like I said, sidearm is the M45A1 with commanding and expert. I'm going to roll off commanding and probably go with tried and true deadly. Of course, this is what's going to help you. Deadly, it's just going to literally just melt people like butter. So I hope you enjoyed the next bit where I take on Lexington on challenge all by myself, just using the riot shield, guys. So yeah, let's go ahead and do Lexington. Lexington event, okay. Challenge, and I'll see you in the next clip. Okay, we're back, guys. Confirmed. That's where they're There we go. By the knees. Right shielded up. I'm gonna kick the hornet's nest by throwing a grenade there. See? One is none is the talent that you really want. There we go, he's down. Now remember what I told you about being flanked? Pop a heal. Red means criticals. Flop. Dead. We can grab these purple mods. We'll grab this guy. Start the mission. Go pop a reload. Yeah. Wah, wah. And don't forget, you can always use the right shield as a melee weapon just when they get to low enough health, guys. Okay. I have done this with a flame turret right shield build. That was absolutely quite fun. That really was fun. But yeah. This is the tried and true. Didn't mean to pop the T skill there, but it went off anyway. See? Right shield's taking all the damage here. We do have a guy flanking behind me. Again, you want to pay attention to your radar. Now, I heard that there was a bug you could do. Where if you opened up caches while doing a challenge event, it can... The caches can give you a chance of giving you an exotic. I don't know if that's truthful or not. Now, couldn't tell you, really couldn't tell you if it's true or not. Like I said, it's just something I heard. Okay, so we prop the bleed on the big guy. That's one guy down. Again, don't be afraid to show your back to an enemy real quick. It means you can just... See, right shield will take most of the grenade points. Gonna pop a heal there real quick. Now, you could use the blue heal. Pop a medkit. You wanna kill this guy first. Because he's the one that's gonna make mincemeat of your shield with his endless non-stop firing LMG, because apparently they have a one is none talent that procs every other bullet. Again, gonna pop a heal. Come at me, bro. Reload. And in that time, notice that my shield did heal. Now, I've seen in some videos where they'll throw the shield away and whatnot. I don't do that. I just like to keep the shield up because, well, why not, you know? It doesn't really hurt the game. Active echo beacon detected. Yay, it ran so fast I beat the... wow, okay. Duh, I forgot to secure the hostage. My bad. Give me a second, guys. I'm in such a rush to get this done, I forgot to untie this poor bastard. Here you go, mate. You're welcome. Now, again, I've noticed that there are some shield build guys that like to use the alternate shield, where it gives them faster reload and everything else, and blah, 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 blah. You really don't need the faster reload. If... You are hesitant on that extra second and a half reload, saving your life, then clearly your build is not strong enough. Clearly your build is not the sign. You're too worried about the emphasis of your riot shield surviving. Mine isn't. I more care about my own survival. Now my T skill is back up, so I'm just to make sure I don't accidentally hit again, because I haven't rebound my reload key yet, so I'm going to tap reload. And I hit my T key by mistake, so I do apologize about that, guys. But it does happen with PCs. Not so much with... Okay, so there's my AR. So we're going to go... Oh dear. Plop. Eat a grenade. Okay, so we're going to do the corner glitch. Oh no, he's charging me. You're dead. Oh no, he's thrown a grenade. Now, that perk's propped. Again, pop a heal. Oh no, grenade. Again, these grenade spam's just way too much, man. Oh no! Let him do his melee thing. Somehow he got behind me. How did he get behind me? Bugged much? I have no clue how he got behind me, but apparently there was a guy behind me. So we're gonna leave that blooper in, because I think that's bullshit. There's no way he could have got behind me, but apparently he got behind me. Yes, there's no need to bloody yell. Agent! Again, we're not glitching, we're using adequate cover. Oh no, he's charging me. You're dead. Okay, so there's both of them. Yeah, let him try and walk. Just focus on one at a time. There you go, he's dead. Now focus on Larry, we've killed Barry. And goodbye. Barry. Pop a heal. There we go, shield's starting to re-heal now. Yeah, you keep throwing those bloody grenades, mate. Switch sides real quick. Got him. Another grenade tossing. Yeah, his own grenade got him. He's down. Gang, pop another heal. Don't be afraid to use your heals. I mean, you got them. Like the age-old saying, the shot never taken is always the shot that always missed. You know? Now that the second sniper's moved up, I can show my back that way. Okay, so that sniper dead. So just the two Varna Trumps left. Come on, Ivana. Come on. Pop, 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 pop. She's dead. Gonna pop a quick reload. Because I can do that while running. So we're gonna run this way. Grab the guy. Uncuff him. Come on, dude. Come on. Thanks for the rescue. You are. Of course they watch over pretty good. Okay, so we're gonna grab our loot. Okay, now we're gonna grab and we're gonna switch over to our flame grenades. Now this is where I would normally switch to a turret, but I'm not going to, because the turret really wouldn't last that long.
Negative, Raymond. You've got
Sniper's dead. Yes. Okay. I'm standing right at it. Open the damn elevator. So I can get to this. Beep. Third floor, menswear. Hello. Press the freaking button already. Do I have to jump up and down on the stupid elevator to get the speed up? Doom, 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 doom. Going. Alright, guys. So, this bit's a little bit tricky because you want to funnel them at you, if that makes sense. I hate the music that's on this part. Doo-doo, 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 doo-doo. It sounds like some sort of African drum techno stuff. Okay, again, you want to be... Kill him. Him. Pop a heal. Kill him. Kill him. Yep. Kill him. Why does it sound your watch, Isaac's watch, sounds like Morgan Freeman with a head cold? Hello, I'm Morgan Freeman. I did the voice for Isaac's in the Division. Again, you want to go for that guy's weak points, and that's why. Okay, pop a heal. Don't be afraid to shoot the weak spots, guys, instead of just the... going straight for the head. Okay. Hi, dude. Little one. Dead. Warning. Incoming hostiles detected. He's dead. Dong, dong, dead. We hit a security lock here. We run this way. Notice I still haven't dropped my shield. I only dropped it once near that elevator. Now it's just to clear off the perspect glass because I'm a bit of a perfectionist that way. Come on. Open up the damn door.
Thank you. Righto. On me way. Off the pop.
Right, so now we're resupplied. Now what I like to do is, now we're in a bit of a lull of the combat. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my cache and I'm going to actually test it. I'm going to open up a cache here real quick. Now I've got a double barrel sawn-off shotgun. Didn't get the barrels. Just meh. I wouldn't call it, you know, broken or anything. Like I said, I like to run and go to the left. Okay, guys, the left. Okay, now it's just me. I'm me, you're you. I do my thing, you do you. Hit. Thing here. Throw that. Thank you. Now, reason why I say hug this area, because she can't get shots on you with her grenade launcher. See? Come on. Kill those guys first. Let her come at you. She's dead now. Green drop. Deadeye, prototype, spec ops pads. So no vest. Boo. That's okay. And there we go. Let's open up the cache real quick. No. Sentry's call is set. I could go with the knee pads. Accolades are triple. Well, you got a 15% chance of the vest dropping. But I would have to swap out the gloves or the holster. Again, most of the other weapons you're going to pick up aren't really going to be worth it. I mean, this one's not too bad. I might keep this one. It's got a fierce, self-preserve, and sustained. I might keep that and give that to my ooh, nice sustained commanding and dominant on a double barrel sawn-off. I might keep those and give those to one of my new turns. But there you go, guys. We just did Lexington on challenge. We can actually throw away the shield now. Thank you. And just walk out the door, as they say. Did I take the wrong turn at Albuquerque? I think I did. No, I didn't. There it is. And yeah, so that is Lexington event done with the defense build, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give the video a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. If you didn't like the video, give me a thumbs down and let me know in the comment section down below why you didn't like the video, what else I could have done that was better. Until then, guys, I will see you in the next video. So keep your ships flying, keep your enemies dying. Cobra Commander is out. Salute.